Hello and welcome. I am James Murphy from mcoding.io, and today we are recovering a problem that I've covered in a previous video. The problem that we're covering again is the first missing integer problem. Last time I covered this problem, I solved it using Python, and I took advantage of one of the problem constraints that the input array size is at most 300. And because I really took advantage of that constraint, the solution that I came up with wouldn't really work if you had much bigger array sizes. So today I'm redoing it in C++, and I'm going to be using an algorithm that will work for whatever array size you want. So just to recap the problem, we're given an input array like this, 3, 4, minus 1, 1, 5, and we're supposed to find the smallest positive integer that is not in the list. So in this case, we have 1 is there, but 2 isn't, so the algorithm should return 2. The way that I'm solving it this time is going to be a lot better than last time because I'm not going to use extra space that depends on the size of the nums array. So this algorithm will work no matter how big nums is. Additionally, it's going to scan through the array at most twice. So here's the idea. For each slot in the array, imagine the number that should be there. So in this case, first we see a 3. And the 3 is supposed to go here. So let's put a 3 here. Now, we clobbered this value minus 1 in order to put the 3 there, but minus 1 is outside of the range of numbers that we care about. So during this algorithm, whenever we encounter a number that's outside the range that we care about, we just ignore it or we stop what we're doing and move on to the next iteration. Okay, so the next iteration, we go through and we see 4. 4 is supposed to go here, so we put 4 there. Now we had to displace 1 in order to put the 4 there, and we do care about 1. So let's continue the process with the 1. 1 is supposed to go in this location, so let's put it there. And we had to displace a 3 in order to do that. So we go to where 3 should be, and we see that 3 is already there, so we stop. Then we continue on to the next iteration, which is here. We see a 3, which is already in the right place, so we move on. We see a 4, already in the right place, so we move on. We see a 5, already in the right place, so we move on. And then we hit the end of the array. We're done with the first pass. Notice now that any element in the array that we care about is in the correct position. So all we have to do is scan through the array and see if the number that we find at that position is the correct number. We look at the first position and we see a 1, that's correct, so we move on. Then we look at the second position and we see a 4, but we're supposed to see a 2. If there was a 2 in this array, it would have moved to this position. So there must not be a 2 in the array, so we can stop and return 2 as the answer. This is an amazingly simple and fast algorithm that gets the job done. So let's switch over to VS Code and code the solution. So first, we just make a loop over the array. If you're wondering why I'm using longs here, the problem statement says that the ints that are in this vector can be all the way up to the maximum possible int and the minimum possible int. And so since we're going to be doing plus or minus 1 kind of things, I went ahead and made these longs in order to avoid overflow issues. Next, we just check for the current element that we're looking at. Is the index a valid index? So current minus 1 is the index that current should go in. Since we're only looking for positive integers and not non-negative integers, the index corresponding to current is just current minus 1. This checks to see if current minus 1 is a valid index, and then this checks to see whether we have looped back on ourselves. So if current were equal to next, then there's nothing more to do. Then inside this while loop, all we do is put current into the location that it's supposed to go, and then replace it with next. After this for loop, all of the positive integers that were in the vector are now in the right places. Then we just loop through the vector again and look for the first index for which the thing at that index is not equal to what's supposed to be there. Of course, it's possible that we never return from this return statement. Everything is in its rightful place, so the first missing thing is the first thing that's outside of the range. So that would be the length of the vector plus 1. All right, so I went ahead and submitted it. It says the runtime was 0 milliseconds faster than 100% of C++ online submissions for this problem. So I can't imagine that no one else has come up with this solution and that this is actually the fastest code that has ever been run for this question. I'm guessing just that anything less than 1 millisecond is deemed 0 milliseconds. And so a whole bunch of good answers get lumped as exactly 100%. So there you have it. There's my second take at the first missing int problem with a much better solution. I hope you enjoyed this one a lot more than the last one. And if you did, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you in the next one.